Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. My name is
Zone.
Drag and Drop, and this is the Epicenter SEA Qualifiers. We're here in a low bracket match between Towering and Rave. Both of these teams, maybe not the met with the most success. We've seen Towering drop 2-0 up against TNC, and Rave, they lost 2-0 against MVP Phoenix. So now it means one of these teams will already be going home, or staying home, or not playing in a tournament anymore. That's my point. Low bracket match, low bracket best of three. The winner will play up against TNC again. So, Powering might have a chance for revenge here if Rave don't take this game off of them. Burn.
Dire team ban.
No, wait. Mineski is their opponent. Yeah. Looked at the wrong place in the bracket, but hey, still. Some ways to go for these teams. My name is Drag and Drop. I'm joined by ModPax. Happy to bring you this game. ModPax, how are you doing?
Oh, I am
10
just,
seconds
I'm
remaining.
fantastic. It is early, but it's okay because everything's fine. I got a little bit of
Radiant
SEA
team
Dota
ban.
coming my way. And it's lower bracket. I mean, come on. Who doesn't love the lower bracket? That's when
Yeah.
things get fun. That's when things get interesting. That's when you never know what is going to happen, especially because we're just rocking through some Epicenter qualifiers. I think people are starting to get a little bit hyped up about this tournament. You know,
10
it's
seconds remaining.
maybe one of these spots where you might see a couple new squads for the first time. I mean,
5
things about to,
seconds remaining.
get a little bit crazy. So
Yeah.
there's plenty of chaos currently in the
30
Dota scene.
seconds
I'm pretty
remaining.
excited just to actually watch some games, you know.
Well, plenty of chaos, but there's still plenty of games being played right now. Especially
Dire
in the
team
Epicenter.
ban.
A lot of SAA stuff that we've been getting. But yeah, we've got Towering versus Rave. A little bit slow on the balance here, maybe. So, really looking to think of a strat that gives them maybe the early game advantage here in this game one.
10 seconds
Being
remaining.
sure to start off into the series with a comfortable draft, maybe.
5 seconds remaining.
Yeah, I think Rave are kind of doing that same thing previously, where they banning a Sven. I believe it was them who
Radiant
had kind of
team
an
ban.
odd first ban last time too. A couple teams doing this kind of stuff. I think if they have first pick lately, where it's like Sven, I don't think you really care if someone grabs Sven in the first phase, but you're leaving. Like, let's say they want to grab like the Nature's Prophet right now, then they get two picks for tearing, and chances are it's still gonna be something nice and juicy left for them.
Vengeful
Or a
spirit.
Ventral Spirit, of course, also another way to go. This way,
Dire
you can be a little bit
team
more
ban.
reactionary as well when you open with the Venge versus like the Nature's Prophet.
Eventually, such a versatile pick that it's never a bad first pick in my eyes. I mean, except if you maybe want to grab the OD really, really badly for a mid, which is still in the pool actually, so I wouldn't be too surprised to see Towering pick that up now. Alongside, I mean, some of these other popular supports like Lion, or maybe
10
a bit
seconds
old school
remaining.
these days, actually, with the Oracle, making sure the
5
OD stays
seconds
alive and
remaining.
keeps right-clicking the fights. Or Faceless Void, some of these more popular
Reserve
heroes
time.
this patch that haven't been
Yeah,
banned
I
out yet.
know they do love their decks here for tearing, so I wouldn't be too surprised if they did grab that. I think that kind of might be the play, honestly. Either the Darkseer and oh, it was them who did the they had the Darkseer and Batrider because they did Yamate with the mid.
Beastmaster.
Okay, so they go with the
Dire
Beastmaster now. I wonder if
team
they're
ban.
still considering like mid bat and Beastmaster seems a little bit crazier. Their mids. What are their other mid heroes? They've been a little bit of an interesting squad coming out lately, you know. They had the Alc mid the other day. That was fun.
Oh yeah, that's like old school stuff. Like it can still work. Alchemist still here. That's it's not easy to play by any means. Sure, you get a
10
lot of gold,
seconds
but
remaining.
there's only
It was
some
painful.
ways. Yeah,
5
there's
seconds
some ways that you
remaining.
can have an impact, and if you don't, then well, if the rest of your team dies because it's falling behind,
Reserve
then your gold
time.
advantage doesn't really matter. So might see it again here. Who knows? But it's gonna be the Invoker, so a bit more standard here.
Radiant
There's your
team
damage
pick.
potential coming out of the middle lane, control from the off lane, control and push as well from both of these heroes. As solid as it gets in my eyes. It still leaves maybe the OD or Death Prophet, some of these other strong mids for Team Rave, or maybe the Zeus if they want to have maybe a bit less of a laning stage potential, but more team fight, more global
10
potential later down the
seconds
line.
remaining.
Yeah, and with him snagged
5
up, then
seconds
it's
remaining.
okay. They're gonna
Oh,
go
they do that,
straight for
yeah.
the PL counter.
Radiant
Yeah.
team ban.
Yeah. All right.
Lots of big heroes still left then, though. Like the OD you talked about, the Nature's Prophet still in the pool, the Darkseer's still there if Rave are interested in having that for themselves, just for their own offlaner. I'm sure they'll take Nature's Prophet if it still remains, or even banning out the Ember, of course, a pretty classic PL counter, but does double up against that Nature's Prophet. And what's up? So the Chen, no real counters yet to that mega kind of push style. Our Lion's still in the pool. Lots of these big heroes still remaining.
It's been interesting to see with these bans coming out with the Sven as well as the Ember. It obviously makes sense if you have a Phantom Lance already picked up. Don't want to have a lot of cleave up against you. Especially now that the Ember Spirit is benefiting so much the more units are there up against them, obviously. It's not as good as people think, I've heard, stats-wise, up against the Phantom Lancer. Well, a really late-game counter, and these days the games rarely go this far, but... Shall see, is the Bad Riders being banned out, so Tyrion don't want to give them that solid laner, that the guy who can always return to the jungle if the lane is impossible for him and gets his levels that way. Don't want to give that to him, over to Rave with that single tile initiation potential, setting up for maybe Phantom Lancer grabbing some easy kills.
Wow, this is kind of scary. They could grab OD here, and one of the big things with OD that you'll see a lot of teams do is the draft gets a little bit unique. If they want to grab a lot of attack speed for an OD. Like, we've seen some safe lane Legion commanders just to give him some buffs. We've seen Ogre Magi coming out to be with the OD and give him the Bloodlust. And right now, they have Beastmaster Aura, and they could even be looking into the Alacrity right now. It would be pretty scary, I think. And they'll even ban the Brood, so whoever's in the safe lane, be it like the Drow, that would be a pretty big opener for them too, just because you don't want Brood up against your Drow, obviously. That's like the best case scenario for a Brood, I think. I kind of like the fact that, like, Taring, with the way that the bans have gone so far, I think the first pick in this phase is going to be really huge. Like, they could go OD, Nature's Prophet. They have a lot of choice here.
Yeah. OD can be still be running that one position, as I said, so it's... They already have Beastmaster with the Inner Beast Aura for the attack speed, so don't necessarily need to go commit heavily if you really want to have that attack speed. You don't have to commit heavily to the Moon Shard or something like that. You already have some extra potential coming from that alone. They also have to start looking at the support here. You mentioned Lion earlier. Definitely wouldn't be a bad one here. A bit of AoE lockdown for the Phantom Lance. So Earthshake would also still be in the pool. These classic counters to that PL, making sure that he regrets having a lot of illusions being spawned. Earthshake, also one of these heroes that can rotate into the mid lane early, and I do assume, because it's SE8, it's going to be a mid Phantom Lancer, right?
Yeah, for sure. It's like the best counter up against the Invoker and Lion, the go-to support lately when it comes to these more slippery and annoying heroes. Means they will get their treasured Nature's Prophet. That's shocking they got Nature's Prophet the second phase, honestly. Like, it's their most picked offlaner, I believe, so far since the team has reformed. So it's pretty surprising they'll grab that late. I'm sure they're very happy with it. Yep. They're actually on a little bit of a slide right now, Rave. They opened up really strong when they first did come back, couple win streaks, you know. But coming in now, like the past, 8 days, they lost MVP Phoenix twice. They then lost to Fnatic twice, and then they lost to Naznedoganyet, which is a team I have never heard of. With the only, I don't recognize any of those players. Yeah. So, not going too well. There's that Drow though, and hence that, you know, that Brood ban kind of triggering it there. So I'm sure Rave are kind of thinking about, like, I know they pick Brood like kind of on Rave, but I mean, you got to watch out for that Drow.
Yep. In right now, I mean, no. Rave still have two picks to deal with it. They also have decent heroes dealing up against the Nature's Prophet can TP right on top. Or close in any case, when Slipper can kind of swap out, put Drow into a bad position. Phantom Lancer can kind of charge in if the gas is off on cooldown, or if Drow isn't quick enough with throwing that one out. But... how do you feel the Drow will fare, actually? I mean, obviously you're going to get a lot of extra damage to the Invoker as well.
I'm kind of wondering, like, I think it'd be kind of cool if they sent the PL top and went aggro up against the Drow. That would catch Taring off guard, I think. even though the PL is so good against mid, if you send him top, he'll just absolutely crush a Drought Ranger plus a Lion. Like, Lion's just such a weak support early, and you do pick PL to kind of dominate the lane. At least lately, that's kind of his whole shtick. Like, yeah, he won't get the bottle as much, so it's a little bit harder, but I don't know, it'd be pretty sick. But more than likely, they're still going to send in mid. I think it'd just be kind of an interesting thing they want to try. But they definitely want something. I think that they can go aggro. Like, why wouldn't you go shut down this Drought? They have a Lion, you have a Ventral Spirit, and a Witch Doctor. Like, to me, they should be going aggressive. And so you're probably looking for... Oh, look, they think it was going to be Super Greed with the support Beastmaster as a possibility.
Yeah. Yeah, if you look at Drave, Witch Doctor, not necessarily known as the most aggressive hero on tri lanes, but if you have a Vengeful Spirit kind of stapling it all together, being in front lines, maybe in that core position, close to the creep wave, able to initiate always, then your supports can be a bit safer and can still follow up after that and can still go for. What else you go for? Maybe something like a Rubick? Just add some extra lockdown, extra burst damage for aggro tries?
Oh, if you wanted to go with like the Venge.
Yeah. You can still go Wraith King here or something like Gyro. I know Wraith King would be bad. Yeah. Gyro would be much better. Juggernaut.
I think Jug though.
Huh.
I mean, they do have the Nature's Prophet, so they don't necessarily have to go aggro. Like, he's gonna do really well up into the line. Just to watch out for the Enigma rotating in. He could probably bully down the Drow at least a bit early, and then maybe there'll be a rotation to help him. But I still like going aggro. They'll probably dodge on the side of Tearing, though.
Yeah. I think they have to. If Rave go aggro, I mean, what's Tearing going to do? Lion, not exactly all that good up against Tri-Lanes early on, unless he had, like, beautiful Earth Spikes every single time. Draw Ranger, not the best laner either. Enigma's going to be in a jungle, going to be farming that one up. Beastmouth in the offlane. Nature's Prophet should be able to deal with him decently well, despite the boar. I mean, you have your own summons to rest back. So, the only thing that Rave really have to be worried about is some good Sunstrikes kind of messing up your math.
Yeah, pretty much. But let's see. Immediate pause. Come on. I'm excited to see where they want to go with this.
The people disconnecting here as we head into our first game of this first best of three in the Epicenter SEA qualifiers. My name is Dragon Drop. I'm joined by Modpax. This is Wraith versus Towering, a lower bracket match, mind you. So if you lose this one, you're out. It's just the cruel world of Dota sometimes. Waiting for both teams to have all the players reconnect and then can get right into this game. The lanes are, at least for Towering, they're kind of set, right? And Invoker's gonna be mid, Beastmaster gonna be in that offlane position. They've got Enigma in the jungle, and then Drow trying to farm up the safe lane with the Lion support. And we've also been talking about Rave's laning potential, or laning possibilities.
Yeah, have they started running up top yet or anything? No, not quite.
Look at that courier. I haven't seen that one before.
On the side of Rave, the two guys carrying it? That one's pretty awesome.
Man, that one is really cool. Excellent sponsorship league. Oh yeah, game starts. Let's take a quick look at our lineups. Starting with Ice here playing for Towering. On that Lion up top, we have Sionix on the one position Drow Ranger. I've got Enigma in the jungle played by Ling. In the mid lane, it's going to be Invoker played by Yamate. And the off lane is going to be taken over by NJ playing that Beastmaster.
Alright, well for Rave, it's going to be Jao. Moving over to the SEA region on the Juggernaut going what appears to be the aggro try that we kind of suspect here. It'll be I hate that bug. It's the worst. Envy on the Venge, Derp, aka Ninja Boogie. Derp gonna be on the Witch Doctor, Rior on your PL, and then Rappy on the Nature's Prophet.
Yep. Rappy there already spamming trains out as you would expect, but yeah, I mean, looks like we might see this aggro try coming out with Derp and Lee and Jay are making their way to the top lane here, wanting to secure the top round. Question is Starling gonna dodge? Can they dodge? I mean, where would that put the Enigma?
Yeah, he can't aggro jungle as well as like an Enchantress or a Chen can, so It looks like they're well aware of what's going to be happening, just by the way the Beastmaster, like, his items definitely suggest that he's going one-on-one against the Nature's Prophet, so they're aware of what's coming towards them. It's going to be really scary. It's only the Salve and the four tangos on the Drow, as per usual. Four tangos up on the Lion. He's going to be having himself a pretty busy time. I love this. They got the right idea with that ward block, though, just to make sure that they wouldn't have anything to pull into for the aggro try.
Sure to take that at least out of the picture. Did you have late the control of the lane, right? That's the most important part, especially if you don't have the best defensive setup to be able to fight into them. Just make sure that you're always last hitting under tower, pretty damn close to the tower over here. Just have to make sure to not have the small creep camp pull contested or something like that. Maybe get caught out there. And then all you need to do is wait for some Enigma rotations, perhaps, coming in, catching Rave off guard, and then you can salvage the lane a little bit, in a sense. Well, let's talk a bit about this mid-matchup. Phantom Lancer versus Invoker is something that has come out of the SAA scene, and it is rapidly spread, though, as an idea to other scenes. What makes this matchup so good for the Phantom Lancer?
It just has so many benefits where it's just like Invoker doesn't go for the runes, so they're kind of free for you. If anyone tries to rotate in and kill you, you're just going to doppelganger and run away. I like never see PLs die mid. It is so rare. It just seems like they're just untouchable. And then with the way bottle, obviously, having your bottle and just either bottle crowing or having supports TP in, you just nonstop spam that Spirit Lance. And Invoker, of course, not going to have any way to dodge that very easily, so... It's just like what could possibly go wrong? It's so good.
Definitely some things. All the spam potential, the sustain, and the escape potentials. Technically, all you need as a mid hero, right? The only downside is that you can't really use your lance to farm if you want to rest with it. Kind of offset also by the high right click damage that he has. He's always going to be able to contest and deny up against Invoker as well if he is in a position to go up to the creep wave without fearing for his life. And first blood being spilled, and that's going to be the ball going down, which is 60 experience for Nature's Prophet, so...
Big win.
Be careful, yeah. I mean, that's a lot of XP early on. There's so much. Almost a bounty rune.
Alright, well, it looks like they have swapped it up, so knowing what's happening and not too shocking here that they'll come down against the Nature's Prophet. Now it'll be interesting to see if there's any sort of rotation that ends up coming out from Rave, as they have brought the Enigma down. So things are about to get pretty wacky down here in the bottom.
Yeah. Might see some music lanes. I've seen a game once where it was an anti-mage involved and a couple of other heroes, but the point is they were dodging lanes left, right, and center. For the first 10 minutes, every two... 1.5 minutes or so, they were just swapping lanes, just trying to make sure they get their carries, the better matchup. Quite fun to watch. Might see this dissolve into something similar, but right now, if you see these dual lanes coming out from Rave, they take care of these Eidolons, which is a decent chunk of gold as well, and now Enigma can't really farm up himself in this aggro jungle position. And it's not like Drow Ranger up against Nature's Prophet is necessarily a bad matchup for the Prophet, right? I mean, if you have Treants, you can spam these out, put them on a Drow.
Oh, yeah.
To rest her quite nicely as well.
Yeah, honestly, J.O. I'm going to have a pretty good time up top as well. I wouldn't be too surprised if Derp made a rotation down. Like, maybe they get some decent control over their lane. Like, you can see Ninja Boogie's making sure they do have the small camp. He's pinging out that they don't have the hard camp up top, so Derp unable to help out here and try and get some control back on that lane.
Let's try to deal with these creep wave now. Bit of a pullover here. See one of these dire creep waves already down here that should give them extra momentum in this lane, which obviously the rave doesn't really want to have happen. It's more free or easy CS for the Drow Ranger, I should say. So far, they're doing a good job keeping her up in terms of the last hit, but obviously much, much harder than this for J.O. here in this position, especially with the help that he's had from Derp, and yeah, he's making his way up top, making sure that this Juggernaut is having a good time. But middle lane now, might see a rotation onto Yamate. NB with the smoke here, they're gonna go on him with his lance as well, so Rush, follow-up stun, and it should be the first blood, especially with Rappy teleporting in here. Sunstrike comes out, actually brings Ryo quite low. not low enough. First blood's still going to go their way. And the forts were just not strong enough to make a trade out of it.
He's just, you know, that's all it takes, right? That one rotation, the slow helping out so much there. It's kind of got everything. And they did have to TP mid as well with Rappy, so missing out quite a bit. Oh, he's going to run ranked all these Eidolons.
Oh, wow.
Unfortunate ice knock on position for the stuns.
I get it across. Not quite. Not quite the right angle. NB still in position here. Takes a bit of harassment from these Eidolons and the big Enigmas. The illusions. Now the Treants are here to save the day in ice. Well, we'll get caught with the cast. NB has another stun available as well. If you can just get in range of it now. After ice's Earth Spike here. There it is. A couple extra right clicks, but it's a annoying position to try and deal with, but it will harass him out far enough that he'll have to chew on the rest of his tangos if he wants to survive much longer.
Alright, well now we're getting a little bit more of this balance that we were looking at here with the both supports down up against the Drow Ranger. Juggernaut will be left to his own devices up top versus Ninja Boogie, but he's, Ninja Boogie. I saw NJ get a little bit confused there up against NJ. And what it just means is that he's got the healing ward. Now the boar is pretty good for that in terms of just like running past and getting it. But if he ever does get low, it's there. And you can see that NJ is already falling behind in terms of the levels. Just about half. Oh, actually, he's caught up now because the wave was just a little bit delayed. But either way, if you're the solo safe laner, quote unquote, he had plenty of support from the Witch Doctor, so I'm sure he's still happy that they're tied.
Yeah, the Witch Doctor, he gets himself yet another free island.
And Yamate, Nickman? Again in trouble. Oh, mid.
They're gonna go again. Bit of help from NB. Ryo with the aggressive doppelwalk. It's a last right click in. That's what you were talking about. That's 3 points up in the lance now. Ability to spam it out with bottle. Bring Yamate low every single time, and then all it takes is one rotation. I mean, the first one was set up by a smoke gang, so this ward actually not helping out Yamate as much as he wanted it to. That's why he was playing so aggressively, but this time maybe a bit less excusable being so far forward.
I think just the best part about this matchup too is that the Invoker always dies, like almost always, in the first 5 minutes, once or twice as you just saw. And it makes it so much harder to go for that Midas that every single Invoker always wants, obviously for the levels and for heading into your Aghanim Scepter, but it's without it, like, they feel more pressured to get something like the Atos or just drums into like an Orchid or something like that, or obviously with the Quest X Sword, it'll probably just be like drums and sometimes even a blink. Like, you might not always see the Midas, and if you do, it takes up to like 15 minutes to get it.
Bottom lane, they're gonna maybe go on derp here. Was stealing some of these last hits here that Ling was going for, but Ice setting up a stun, not quite pulling the trigger just yet. That could have been an easy kill. They had got that off with Raw Ranger right next to them there. Not quite with this level 6 yet, though, so the big damage is still missing from the draw. But meanwhile, top, Ninja Boogie, he's playing the Roaming Venge style. It's quite fun to watch. You're just looking for opportunities anywhere in the map. Has been successful in mid. Now NJ, he's just running straight into him. He is stunned. Comes out. JO's there. Does not have the Omni Slash. So they need a bit of extra help. And that's going to come from Rappy. Gets the Sprout up, but that'll be eaten through. NJ will be able to survive this one.
Yeah, they'll bring up the prop though, and obviously only the 1 point in the axe is kind of standard build these days. They really want to apply this pressure, I think. Rappy's already got a TP though, so he might head home and just get ready to head back and defend his bottom, because the push has arrived, and Drow Ranger not really shut down. Going aggro, having the Enigma there. He's not as far as maybe you'd like your Enigma to be, but he's certainly not behind. Like, not too poorly.
I mean, sometimes you see Enigmas already with level 6, level 7 by this point in the game if they have complete free farm in the jungle. Obviously, it's not gonna be as easy if you go aggro jungle like that. And yeah, they haven't really died down here. And now they might get to kill themselves here. Derp caught with Cold Snap in the back with the Yamate's rotation in. They're gonna be enough to bring him down here with the Force Spirit. Not quite here. Survives at 7 HP.
You're not
gonna
send it? Oh, come on. You send the Forge Spirit, I think. That was really weird. Why wouldn't you just send the Forge Spirit?
I don't know.
You didn't have tangos? He had one. He had no tangos. Alright. Alright, Yamate, please. That is, like, not okay.
That's where when you play Deus Ex, you get this merciful soul achievement for not killing anyone. Mid lane though, Yamate, well, they're not gonna be as understanding here. They're gonna try and bring down the Invoker. Take them a little bit longer here, Rappy jumping quite low. Now with the Enigma coming in as well, Lumber, I have extra right clicks. He will be also falling here. Lion also down drain a little bit earlier. Making it a 3-for-1 trade at the end of the day, so
Man, Rearo's gonna be so rich.
Oh yeah.
He's already up to 4200.
Yeah, he has 4 kills. On his mid Phantom Lancer. Showing us what this Siri can do in this position.
He can start moving into those boots. Like the boots of travel soon too. I mean, I think that should definitely be his item choice this game.
Alright, what's a trade-off? Down here in the bottom lane, we've got Sionix. He's kind of split pushing a little bit here, putting on pressure on tier 2. He could have actually gotten a couple of right clicks off perhaps with an ultimate as well.
But there's a roar on Rior. Sunstrike.
Would be a big kill if they could get it here, but stick charges, doppelganger.
PL.
It's kinda hard, down to the low ground. And now the Omni Slash comes out. Hits a couple of times onto NJ, a couple of extra right clicks will do the trick. And Raya, he will survive. Goodbye.
What a hero.
Man.
It's like almost got his bots now too. Thanks for the assist.
It's like the new Ember Spirit. I mean, Bottle, Aquila, Boots of Travel, Unkillable. Right?
Yeah, pretty much. Except he can crush an Invoker mid.
Yeah.
He's got everything going for him. And now you can see the pings coming out here. Just from the Witch Doctor, like, hey, we see the draft, she's by the Ancients, we gotta keep an eye on that that Roshan, so nice big way they can get back into this game. They're not too crazy far behind, it is 3k.
Yeah.
Mostly just over the past couple of minutes, though, in that, like, mid-engagement.
Skills definitely adding a lot to the tally. Tubbs Gold is Wallace experience here, about 1,000 only in favor of Wraith, but obviously these towers making quite a big impact as well. Already having lost a tier 1 mage as well as top. And, well, it just puts a bullseye on this tier 1 tower in the bottom lane, so I wouldn't be too surprised. See Wraith put on pressure there now. Trying to take that map control away from Tauri, making it that much harder to go for this Roshan. We've got Jayo down here now, farming up. He has the Hands of Faith boots going through drums with the brace already. Actually, yeah, that's the robe of the Magi on Akura. All he needs now is the recipe, which he almost has, and yeah, we should see similar things soon for the Draw Ranger. Maybe go up top, farm some extra items, complete the Helm of the Dominator. Right now, we still got NJ here. He's level 8, so in terms of levels, that's more than you sometimes see from Beastmasters in the offlane. Obviously, being in the safe lanes, it's a bit easier to get. But can they really make use of that? I mean, the first roar that we've seen has ended up being ineffective.
It was close. Maybe once Isis finger it'll be easier.
In trouble here. Is that Cold Snap? There's a Sunstrike. We'll connect here. Cold Snap just keeping him in place, but now Ice will be able to stay alive as it's just the couple of illusions Ryan sent his way.
A little bit of a gold exchange coming back their way. But those boots of travel are now up. Now bottom lane, they're on the drow.
Yep. They got him with the spin here. The cast bouncing back. Black hole though, but the spin is still going. Drow is dead. That's a death roll from the outside. Ling will get brought down in the first black hole of the game. Ineffective here. NJ. He comes in. He gets a roar off here. Ninja Boy might fall, but NJ should as well. They've got a Maledict on top of him. Ryo is there. Throws out one more lance here. Yamate with the cast as well. The Omni Slash comes out. Nothing to bounce into. But now Jayo might still die to force, but there it is in the tower shots. But no one's getting the XP from that. Ice coming back in as well, right? They can just turn us around with another lance, but they have to deal with these force spirits first. And doing a decent amount of damage at this stage in the game, so I don't know. Still really questioning that continued TP from Beastmaster kind of feeding himself away.
Yeah, it did kind of work out though, I guess, like, in some ways, yeah. But they certainly came out on top still for Wraith, losing the Invoker, losing the Drow, losing the Enigma, losing the Beastmaster. It was
losing that black hole as well. I mean, it's 2 minutes now, 1 or 2 minutes where Wraith don't have to worry about that, and they want to push again.
Yeah, and that's also a little bit of the threat that they'd be missing, like kind of around the Roshan pit as well. They will have the Necro Book up here soon for the Beastmaster, but they're gonna a smoke up before that. But there's a ward in that tree line. I'm not sure what that actually sees. It does see that full thing. Okay, so they're fully aware they just smoked. So they know they're in the Rosh pit.
Can I contest them though? I mean, they have Jayo here. There's no Omni Slash either, so that has been used. They have another Death Ward. They have. And Nature's Prophet also went in a little bit, but this Roshan is falling pretty damn quickly. Yeah. They didn't know, I mean, just didn't feel they could contest. Yeah, it's, well, three ages. Always nice for Taran to come back into the game as a little bit earlier. Now that nice deny on the double damage rune. Ninja Boogie will at least get the creep, maybe? There it is. 76 extra gold for that vengeful spirit. And now Rave then faced by that extra life on Taran. They want to put on more pressure on the tier 1 tower. It's been dropped fairly low. Now Rapid coming in on the side. Another TP in from Ryo. They actually can Jamonte with a stun as well as the lance here. Need a bit more damage here. That's gonna be from Jayo coming in. Deathward as well. Being focused on Yamonte, not quite enough to bring him down. He will stay alive, Ling. Maybe not so lucky here, taking so much extra damage. Now Sionix in frontline takes a bit of extra rackets from that, as everyone else is still alive from Rave, apart from the Vengeful Spirit. Now they have to start to run away, perhaps, as Sionix. Well, he's actually dropping quite low, so there's Malefus on top of him. A Maledict in this case. Both spells in the same game, it's kind of hard to keep track of, but yeah. Towering, 1-for-1 trade in the end? Looks like it, yeah.
You'd think Ryora had a Diffusal Blade or something, the way he's just shredding them apart. Yeah.
So much damage being done by the Phantom Lancer. He's getting closer to the Diffusal Blade, right? He already has Blade of Alacrity. After the Woods of Travel, so...
And they're gonna see with that ward that they are grouping up, they're coming back in, but this time the Omni Slash, it'll be ready, they'll be in a better position to use it. Death Ward won't be available this time, which is pretty great for zoning these towers, but as you can see, Taran, well aware of what's coming, they're just gonna back out. Highly unlikely to be able to save this.
Yep.
No point risking that Aegis for this, and... I don't know, it doesn't look like they want to stop, though.
I mean, I really like Taran's movement, though. They spread out across the map, recognizing that they cannot defend this tower with that being so low health. Some of your own spells committed as well, so instead they just go to the mid lane, go to the top lane, split push a bit, farm up a bit. The jungle as well with these Eidolons, so get as much as you can off the map, and now losing NJ. Bad position, that was a swap used, a bit more excusable. That's another tier 2 going down. Do they stop here? Do they keep going? I don't think you do with the Aegis still on the field and the other towers.
Me had the Boots of Travel on your PL, so.
Yeah.
Yamate? Found out here.
Oh. As the Ghost Walk, they do not have detection by the looks of it.
So, oh, Yamate, is he gonna get greedy?
Oh. Rappy will TP out, he should be fine. Alright, so looking at this game now, obviously Rave with the advantage, right? I mean, that Phantom Lance is sitting at 8.3k net worth. This is the Fuse Blade finished, so he's gonna be more fighting effective, combat effective, I should say, than he already was.
This is terrifying. Hopping on top of that Drow, hopping on top of the Invoker. Oh man, like Enigma is one of those heroes too that has so many mana issues. And he has the mechanism up as well, so
yep.
If he gets on top of him before he, like, casts the mech, I think that would be the big target.
Alright, here, the Spartan Yamate, Cold Summon, Rapid though, kind of getting being caught on front lines, he will die first! Now he don't have that extra right click, these extra trees to play with, but... Tower, down to half health, Sionix is getting a couple of extra right clicks off, but... Should really be able to finish it off if Ryo wants to keep spamming illusions here.
Yeah, still gotta respect that right-click damage coming from a Drow lineup, and
yep.
Rappy asleep at the wheel a little bit there. I think he might have thought that Ninja Boogie was closer for a swap or something like that, and maybe hoping to bait some people in. Oh, Jayo, he's going! Oh, he wants it! Oh!
This would be a good Omni Slash level 2, so you can get quite a bit of damage off, but you can't really guarantee a kill with everyone grouped up that much. Ryo is starting to run out of mana. Rappy is back, though. They catch Jing inside the Sprout here, forcing out a spell. Now even the Death Ward being committed to make absolutely sure this here is taken out of the picture. And now, a couple of Treants up there following, tanking some tower shots. And now trying to take care of this tier 2. No fear whatsoever without the Black Hole on the field.
Yeah, and the mech too is just so huge to them right now, and the way these fights go. Like, the last thing Rave wants is to dive in too deep. The mech pop comes up, and Invoker manages to get some sort of a turnaround. Like, maybe he's not the one who's being focused down to mana burns. And just by snagging one hero, though, this whole, like, idea of a defense from Taran totally falls apart. And I love the way that they're just not going too crazy. Like, you have Boots of Travel up on your PL. There's no reason to try and go high ground right now if any of the lanes are pushed, right? Like, just go get the free farm that's there. Your Nature's Prophet can head into the other wave, as you can see.
Yep.
And they can even just keep waiting out this Aegis, which only has just about 5 seconds left on it.
It's definitely not enough to make anything else happen with that. I mean, Rafe are getting everything they want. They're continuing to bolster up their gold. their gold advantage up to 5k now. Experience a little bit more even with the way Towering has spread out. But now they need some kills to go their way as well. They might find Jao here. He TP'd into spins.
This could be like the best bait ever.
Yeah, Rappy and Derp are here. Now Ice and Yamate, they have to be on the run. They cannot fight this alone. Being outnumbered and all class and sense as well. Middle tower being denied, so a little bit less gold going away towering either. Sunstrike! Oh! And Ninja Boogie there. Almost dying to that, actually. But not quite. Meanwhile, down in the bottom lane. Pushed out completely here. Will not do any chip damage to the towers. Unix is here. Take care of that, but just be careful not to be just run down, I guess.
Well, here's maybe some comeback potential here, right? You're gonna have the blink dagger up in just a moment here for Ice. If he can keep focusing down Rior, like if they can make some sort of a play to actually kill him on these side lanes, then delay time for the Invoker so he can get up in some of these bigger items, maybe the Aghanim Scepter, a blink dagger, someone who can actually set up a decent AoE for the Enigma to, you know, take advantage of. And then NJ also, he's still stuck on that level of Necro. Oh, that cask. Oh, that's good second war.
Yeah, now Rappy's dead. Enough time for him to benefit. Now there's the Omnislash coming out, bringing him down. A couple of swipes on top of Necro Creeps as well. They will wrap these up. And oh, Sunstrike. Share between and Ninja Boy and the Rappy a bit. So he will not die to that, especially with the healing ward going. It's another free pickoff.
All right, there were like four spirits, Necros. A couple of boars, that was pretty unlucky for poor NJ, but he was probably dead either way. Just like those Omni Slash bounces, jeez, like Jao. Go buy a lotto ticket or something, man.
Yeah.
Those were looking pretty fine. One tower remaining. Four heroes now rotate at the top with Rior available anytime. And you can see they're trying to set up for this play. It would be Black Hole and Finger.
It is. That's kind of double walk off, though. But,
yeah.
Now Ling.
And that's just like shit.
Alright, abort. Back to base. But yeah, so should talk about the skill build of Phantom Lance. I mean, he's now starting to put points in Doppelganger, but he went for a couple of levels in stats earlier. How do you feel about that one?
I think it's kind of player dependent on the whole Phantom Rush. Some people really like it, like for just the non-stop possibilities of aggression, but other people feel that the stats values are more important. This game versus Invoker and the Lion, I could see that in the Midnight Pulse as well. Like maybe just having a little bit more HP with everything being burned away from you could be pretty handy.
Engagement up top is trying to deal with this push coming out. They already used the meatball on the Invoker just to deal with the creep wave. But well, up against Nature's Prophet, always gonna have creeps, always gonna have trains. To be to frontline for you, take some of these tower shots. This is just an 4v4 up here in the top lane, and now TP comes in. They want to fight now. Ryan's then front lines. What? There's a blink, there's a hex, there's a finger of death here. Swap out there to keep him safe. Nicely done. Wrong to NB. Still die for sins, but there's a death ward coming out, making sure that they can't really go any further, but it's not doing enough damage. With the rest of Rave also retreating, Derp might just have to give up his own life. Throws it under the cask and resigns to his fate. So Towering didn't get the kill that they wanted. But I get two other ones, at least on the support, so you're gonna take what you can get at this stage, I think.
Oh man, they wanted that so bad on the PL, but obviously with no Blink Dagger or anything, it's pretty difficult for NJ to reach him there with the Roar and just has to go for the Vengeful Spirit instead. But that's okay. It's gonna allow them to put a little bit of pressure back on the map, maybe get out some Observers of their own, because you can see these ones from Rave really paying off as they were recently put down.
Now it's finally Towering's turn.
Jao, he is Omni!
Okay, he's going to use the Yamate. All of that being spent on him. Black Hole comes in. Not really doing anything. There's no follow-up here. Jao protecting himself against a lot of that damage. Has Healing Ward going now to keep him alive as the Enigma dies to the support coming in from his own team.
And I mean, there wasn't even a Midnight Pulse there.
Yes. And Jao will be tracked down inside the trees. Obviously, it's not a safe realm if you're up against a Nature's Prophet. Trying to eat his way through here, but there's an extra sprout to keep the vision up and running. So it's three more kills. This is how the cookie crumbles, right? You just took a good team fight. You're split pushing down in bottom lane, but Phantom Lancer will be able to take care of that, while the rest of the team once again puts some pressure on this last remaining tier 2 up top, which has fallen pretty damn low in that last engagement.
Oh, that's rough. Like, you feel like you finally got some momentum, so you try and push it into just... It's just tier one, right? They're not going to fully contest, right? And then, obviously, they ran into a couple issues. But Roshan's back up. They might be in some position to grab it. Wow, I had not sniped that she was working on that. All right, no. So knowing that the push is coming, got to be going for Agnum Scepter Chain Lightning build, I'm sure. Soon to come.
I've actually never seen that in a pro game. I'm really excited now. Obviously makes a lot of sense up against all these illusions.
Does it not have an animation?
Should. Oh. It does, yeah. It's just really close to each other, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, it bounces from one to the other. Okay, it's not like Medusa. I thought they like came out at the same time, I see.
Hits so they, the first target, then it splits it to one.
Okay, alright. And then it hits two after, is that right?
Yep. Okay. Two after at half damage. But yeah, it's with Drybinger right now. But 250. 250 damage here. Half of that is still pretty significant, actually.
I mean, it is wrecking through those treants, but look at their wrecking through its Roshan.
They're gonna blink in here, yeah, ice. No, not gonna snack the Aegis here, Jay. Ryo picking that one up. No, nice little Malefice, everything onto Rappi. He's dropping quite low, and now this Deathlord coming out from the high ground. Not really doing too much. Yonix cleaning house here, Omnislash not quite as effective. 2 years down just like that. And they will get the Juggernaut as well.
Right.
After popping the Aegis... Oh, wait. Fenplant's at the Aegis. He got out. Juggernaut not really benefiting from that one, so... I didn't expect Towering to be able to do that without Black Hole, but they just put the damage where they needed it to.
I think it might have been because the way Rave positioned was very different than the way they would have if Black Hole was up, but it was still super good for not only the fact, like, the blink in from Ice was super effective just because they were all grouped up in the pit where you normally wouldn't be. They had the Black Hole, and the Midnight Pulse did a lot of work that fight as well. Plus, I think the main thing was that Rior actually doppelganger to that high ground, like, right away, so he wasn't there to actually output any damage, and when he's not there, you know, not nearly as scary of a lineup, I don't think.
Oh, Yamate will catch Rappi, or maybe it's the other way around. Ninja Bucky says, well, they have the silence from the Orchid of Nature's Prophet. That's an easy kill on the Invoker. Ouch. In yeah. Towering, they pull out these good team fights every once in a while, but then they seem to throw it away straight off the bat. Straight after.
And you see that that little bagel in Rior's kill score, the 8-0 and 7? He's not turning that into breadstick anytime soon, because he has got the Heart of Tarrasque and the Aegis of the Immortal. And he still has all 8 defusal charges. Man, this guy is skimpy. He does not just throw those away for anything.
Can you actually kill him right now?
It's no. It's like Black Hole with full duration right clicks from the Drow.
Ryo, he feels
here
it.
We go. Look
he
at
has
him go.
No fear. Dodges the silence here. Link dropping quite low. Want to take that Black Hole out of the picture for good. There it is. No buyback in this one. Ryo, well, he can just stand there for a couple of seconds, wait for his half to heal him up. He doesn't give a damn. Being canceled now by these illusions from the Dark Avenger, which is quite annoying, but it's still the healing one. Be taken out. They did finish up the tier 3 and now slowly chipping away at the racks. Now, Sionix might be in trouble here. Swap back into everyone on the side of Rave. The Roar. Giving him maybe enough space, but they do get the stun up. They do get the Death Ward in place. And it's a Draw Ranger down and drain without buyback either. So this might be at least a set of racks. Maybe two with the top 3 wave pushing in as well. Meatball comes out trying their best to do the latest, but don't think they can.
Well. They have a Agnum Scepter Drow, so, you know, yeah, she didn't finish off the Manta, which definitely saved her life in that fight with a nice magic missile dodge, but at least she might be able to go into a Maelstrom if there happens to be any buildings left when she finally respawns. Enigma's back, he's got the Blink Dagger. It's the desperation plays.
They're definitely gonna need a Black Hole if they want to hold a second set of racks here, because Darwin just... The thing is, Darwin just not gonna be able to bite that extra damage now, right? He's just going in deep, burning away at that mana, making it hard for Link to go blink in. Looks like Rave, they don't want to take a chance here. Let's take what they got. Look at Yamate, he's dropping so low to just AMP ultimate as well as the illusion chipping away at him.
Is that an Aether Lens Venge, aka the best item in the game?
It is indeed.
Digging it.
There's also an Agnum Scepter on that Witch Doctor, so he's been slowly and quietly farming that one up without even... on top of the Arcane Boots as well, so it's... Looks like he straight up rushed it. Also mining some support items there with a still holding onto dust as well as the smoke. Really, really good timing on that one.
Oh well, I mean,
the Lancer,
Maybe there's a chance, right? Once this Aegis is gone. I mean, there's always a chance, so there is.
There's always, yes.
You gotta believe, you know, the Invoker, he can get up into something a little bigger. I do like the Blink Dagger. I think it's gonna make it so that he can be effective in these fights. Like, the Aghanim Scepter wouldn't have been done by now anyway, and this is a pretty big help.
Yep.
Get a couple more items up on our drow, you know?
It's a bit backing on fact, or backing on hope maybe, that Rafe is overextending a bit, maybe grouping up a bit too much. Thing is, Ryo is doing a really good job just trying to keep the pressure on Link, keep the illusion to stop him to make sure that he can't just blink in and black hole a couple of heroes at a time.
He still has 30 seconds left on the Aegis, he needs to like go YOLO.
Yeah.
Like, get in there, man. Like, there's no way they're gonna get the follow-up kill if there's anyone else alive, because someone should be able to swap the Enigma or anything.
Just taking care of these Eidolons. Max is taking a bit of damage as we have a pause coming out, which is unfortunate, but a bit of a lag spike, obviously. Not what you want in this kind of a situation.
No, you certainly needs the greatest combo of your life here. Can't be handling that right now.
Alright, so I would assume Towering have timed the Aegis. I'm probably just waiting for it to go down, that they're gonna make their play. What's the dream scenario here? I mean, obviously a big black hole.
Ninja Boogie and Derp Derp fall asleep with their keyboards, I guess. Because like the way they're playing right now, it just means like, what are you gonna do? Like, Taring needs to go into the back line and get a double Earth Spike onto Ninja Boogie and Derp, which isn't even possible because of the way they're standing. And at the same time, Ling needs that three-man black hole that you can see there. And Sionix just has to like right-click down Rior. And he still has the Aegis, though. So you finally do that, and I feel like he's just gonna come back and kill all of you.
Well, game is hard. Game is very hard as we head back into it. Oh, looks like Rafe just want to say, alright. Maybe they had some more fearful scenarios in their heads than we did in ours. So just gonna leave it be for the time being. Knowing that the Aegis is gonna expire now, so... that was the moment the Towering would have gone for if Rafe was still up on the high ground as it stands, so I'm just gonna, once again, go back to farming. Ryo with these Boots of Travel is very effective that sends throughout this entire match, sitting at 16.6k net worth. What is he going for next? Just a straight up Butterfly, take up more? Or Mantis style, maybe?
Yeah, no, that could, I'd be pretty down with the Butterfly, honestly. Even a Blink, frankly, for Rior, I think would be kind of sick. But he still has the Marie Aquila too, so you could eventually sell that to grab a Blink if this game ends up going that long. But I feel like if he just gets on those back lines, that, like, without having to use his Doppelganger and he gets on top of them, what are they even going to do with how tanky he is right now? I just feel like there would be no answer. Especially if he ends up, like, if he gets an Aegis and he just hit a Blink or something. I don't know. I don't know how you kill them. So, we'll see. He's got a couple different options he can go for.
Even if they can bring the damage on top of him, they're still Ninja Boogie. This Vengeful Spirit is always standing just close enough behind Ryo to be able to swap him out at any moment. Then all of the stuff that you use to try and bring down this Phantom Lancer kind of goes to waste, because then, sure, maybe you get Ninja Boogie, but does that really matter? The Phantom Lancer is just going to heal up from the heart, and moments later, it's just gonna wreck your face.
Yeah, exactly. Like, Ninja Boogie might even get out, potentially, like, depending on that positioning that actually is there, and then they have the healing word and heal him up too, and they just go back in, but here we go, they're gonna try something here.
Yep, I have a spin and a bit of...
No Invoker, though.
Both right clicks in. Hey, he's up on the top lane, TPing back now, but tier 3's... tier 1 top, actually. Is gonna fall, so... that one was still up. A little bit of extra gold going away. Taro, we can take a look at buybacks. And... they have some available here. Drow has it, same for the Invoker, same for the Enigma, so the important targets have. Now there's the Blink Roar onto Jao. Can it do anything off of this? Meatball comes out, but the spin as well still. Plenty of damage onto Jao, perhaps. There's a black hole, and the back catches absolutely everyone, but the damage will stay still from the Death Ward. Doing so much work. Yamate, next one on the list. He will fall, and they need to start buying back here if they want to hold those racks. But the black hole is down. This was one of the big controlling fights. Yeah, Ryo is still alive. Juggernaut doesn't even matter as much at this stage, but gonna need to have a lot of mileage out of the Star Ranger. Yeah. And looks like they're respecting the split shots Maelstrom. for the time being.
Yeah, no point continuing that fight, really, without your Juggernaut and your Vengeful Spirit there, so they force out the buybacks. It's a win in their books, but also for Taring, a little bit of success. Just the fact that they are still in the game, which is probably more than they might have been suspecting coming into that fight. Big black hole now from Ling, and won't have that for another 150 seconds. He, as most Enigmas kind of do these days, he doesn't go for the extra points in it, but it does mean the cooldown doesn't get shortened at all, which starts to hurt you as you're getting up and up towards like level 16. He might have to start going back into it for these, consecutive defenses. It's Rear Decidlin. Yeah, he is going for that butterfly. Right. So that will be next on the list. Oh, Rappy here. Got the Orchid, got the Agnum Scepter. Not looking too good here for the side of Taring. Dragon drop? Uh-oh.
Ah, God!
What? you're back.
I've muted. I'm sorry.
That's okay. I was just like, yeah. Hello?
I was hitting the cough button and then I forgot to unpress it. But I'm back. Yeah, the army approaches here in the bottom lane.
Ryan, you're here for when it matters.
Yeah. Hashtag production value. Yeah, there it is. They're just slowly but surely chipping away. I mean, it's kind of annoying to deal with all these summons as well, all the creeps respawning. Just because it's restricting your movement, right? If nothing else, even your own treants can kind of make it hard to go on a target that you want to, even with the Phantom Rush, even with the Doppelganger. Get unlucky there. Now the Ice Walls slow everything down as well. And none of the other lanes are really pushing in far enough to keep towering back for the time being. Middle lane is now starting to, and Yamate, oh, swapped out, he was standing! What the hell was he doing there? He was just standing there! On the stairs now, they almost bring down Ninja Bug here, they will with a couple of extra right clicks on the ball, but there's a roar onto Raya here, can they bring him down in time? Yes, they can with the follow-up hacks! He can buy back and TP in if necessary, he has a death ward, does a decent amount of damage, but he has to blink out. Else he dies, so 2-for-2 trade here, but they do get that big, big hero off the board, finally, in Draw Ranger. Getting that gold, so all of a sudden, that MKB might be on the list.
I'm a little surprised, considering they know that the Invoker bought back. I'm kind of surprised Rior's not buying back, but I guess he really just wants to get into that butterfly. And again, there's no point risking it. You're definitely going to win this game. Like, there's still like a 90% chance you win this, so you don't have to go too crazy. And doing things like immediate buyback to try and end it is one of those ways that you can just lose if they get another, like, they actually do use the black hole, let's say, and kill you on your buyback.
Yeah.
That's my favorite sound in the whole game. Oh, my Beastmaster gets the
TP room. Oh no, the TP onto the tree and will be denied! Phantom Lancer is not going to be here anytime soon for this fight, so Towering a bit of extra space to try and deal with this Roshan before Rafe can really go in. But this has been from Jay. We really wants to annoy them. Then Jay dropping quite low to that. So is the Omni Slash available? He just straight up falls off and bash from Roshan. Jay dropping low, but so is Ling. The fight is real. Ninja Boogie back. And now the cast of Sionix. Nice. Therefore, from outside the pit, three heroes are down just like that. Sionix next one on the list. We'll get the Roshan though. We'll get the Aegis, but he should die a second time here. Without a blink tag, but there's Yamate in the back. Can he provide the control? Maybe! Deafening Blast on 3, but Sionix.
Yo, Yamate's ditching. He's out of there.
This was almost really, really good now. Actually, they catch Yamate here. They don't have the detection, though. Not quite yet, Derp. Dust on cooldown. They see him now. They have a gem, so they don't even need the dust. Yamate will end up falling, making a 5-man wipe. Force at the buyback as well. On Draw Ranger, just to defend this top lane. Was pushed in by the trains. And yeah, story of the game maybe for Towering. I mean, they take a good team fight, but then they kind of throw that away right after.
Yeah. Close though.
It was close. I mean, Ryo, he was tipping to one of these trains. they got cleaned up pretty heavily with him going into the pits, so he wasn't there initially for the fight. So it was a bit
Oh yeah, it
would have
been like way different. You can even see Ling though, to be fair, he was lining up for the black hole anyway. If he did come in, there probably would have been like the immediate doppelganger into the dodge of the black hole, and he probably would have been really sad, but
I mean, I've almost said if Taring would have stopped committing to the Roshan, instead went out to fight them, fight Wraith, without the Phantom Lancer. Even with the Black Hole, I mean, they would have probably had a chance. I mean, as stacked as Ryo is, I don't think he would just go 1v5, the rest of his team's kind of sent packing.
Alright, well, once again, and top lane, it is still the melee that's surviving, so that's probably the only reason they're actually still in this. Like, if they could sneak, like, right now, I feel like he should just TP and kill it from Rapey. Rappy, rather, jeez. Sorry, Rappy.
It's a bit of a more offensive way to say his name, I suppose.
I know, it's brutal. But he's just like sending the treants right now, and if he was to just... I feel like there's so many Nature's Prophet players that would TP right on top of that right now and just like blink into the trees and give his team a chance to just clean up bottom at the same time. Like, they're not splitting enough.
Just literal space creation, man. Raya also not really committing into this range tracks just yet.
Look at the treants on it! They're gonna lose that melee.
Yeah, they have the range glyph down there as well. Kind of slipped the focus here, one set of racks. Now there's the TB action. Oh, just faked it out. But the racks are dead anyway. And Rafe just falling back again. They even have the cheese on Phantom Lancer, so Ryo picked that one up. Interestingly enough, so. There it is. Link Hex. So follow up, he doesn't care. There's the Roar, there's the Death Ward on the side, doing so much work here. Look at the bounces. Top of the cast, he has 3 heroes dead just like that. Ryo not even touched by this. There's doppelgangers across the gas, I'm just showing next. He will fall a second time. This is GG right here, right
oh,
now.
Oh, yeah!
We'll get the 5-man wipe with the Sprout on the Link as well. He makes his way back to base, I suppose.
God damn, the Doctor is in. Derp with the insane plays. Like, the last 4 fights, the Death Wards have been unreal. They have totally saved some of the fights that were going, like, poorly, and then they also just totally cemented the lead. Like,
without a doubt.
Brave, they looked good that whole fight, and Rior props to him, 11. Wow, that's a nice little kill score right there. 1-1-1-1-1. He's like writing code or something. So well played by Rave. I don't know, you know, a little bit of a slump. It's nice for him to get a win. I don't think Taring had the worst game, though, considering the draw pick was, some would say, a little bit odd. Like, just the Enigma and the Lion. You kind of get forced in that greeny mode whenever you do have the draw without, like, enough right clickers, I guess, that are going to be helping out with that.
And yep.
They just couldn't quite get to work. Rior just got totally out of control. I'm expecting a PL ban, honestly, next game.
So I think with the Enigma pick, I think if you get into a position where you have to rely on the Enigma to find good black holes, you're already in a really bad position because you just cannot guarantee them at this level of play. So if you pick an Enigma, you have to really make sure that you get mileage out of him early by pushing down towers, grabbing the momentum for the rest of your team instead. But it just didn't quite happen here up against Rave, who had the better lane straight up. I mean, Jarranger got the farm, but no one else really did. Invoker was shut down. Beastmaster couldn't really shut down a Juggernaut at the top. But yeah, that was game one. This is the best of 3, so Taring still have a chance to come back with a bit of a different strat perhaps in game number 2, which will be happening in just a couple of moments' time, so don't go anywhere.